There are no doubts the two most popular mid-size jets are the Boeing 737 and the Airbus A320 families. I've been lucky enough to fly and get some good experiences on both the Boeing 737 and the Airbus A320s during my 13 plus years career as an airline pilot. In today's video, I will make a comparison between these two aircraft types, and at the end, I will tell you which I think is the best. This is just my personal opinion based on my own experience. Let me know in the comments below which aircraft type do you prefer, the Boeing 737 or the Airbus A320s families. So let's talk about it. V1 rotate. First of all, I have to say that I have an extensive experience on the Boeing 737. I've flown this type as a cadet, first officer, captain, training captain, maturing approximately 8,000 hours of flight time on this type, while my experience on the Airbus A320 is limited. As of today, I've just finished my type rating as a direct entry captain for an European airline. I will compare the Boeing 737 and the Airbus A320 families on the following aspect: handling, so manual flying without the autopilot, normal operation and non-normal operations. Before comparing these two aircraft, let me tell you what are, from my point of view, the two main differences between the Boeing 737s and the Airbus A320s. 1. The Airbus A320 is a fly-by-wire aircraft. It means that when you make an input on the side stick to turn left or right, pitch up or pitch down, you will send an electrical signal that is processed and checked by computers. And once that your input is processed and controlled, it is sent to the flight controls actuator that will move your ailerons, elevators and so on. So there are no mechanical linkage between your side stick and the aircraft surfaces. The Boeing 737 is not a fly-by-wire, so the flight controls are linked mechanically to hydraulic power control units that moves the surfaces such as the ailerons and elevators. So when you make an input on the yoke on the Boeing 737, it moves the surface directly, like a Cessna 172. The second biggest difference is the ECAM, or Electronic Centralized Aircraft Monitor. This is a system that monitors and displays to the pilot the information regarding engine and airplane systems. On top of that, the ECAM, in case of a system malfunction or failure, will display the affected system and the related non-normal procedures that you have to follow in order to deal with the problem. The Airbus A320 is equipped with ECAM, so if you have an engine failure, this system will alert you, showing exactly what is the failure, what are the actions that must be done, and what is the overall situation of the aircraft with a specific failure. On top of that, this system monitors the majority of the aircraft switches, so it will alert you if you forgot something during the checklist. The Boeing 737 is not equipped with ECAM, so there are almost no systems that monitors the pilot's actions during normal or non-normal checklist. Airbus A320 versus Boeing 737 handling, manual flying. The Airbus A320 auto-trims your inputs. Let's say you are flying with autopilot disengaged and you want to climb with a pitch attitude of 10 degrees. You take the side stick, pull it aft until the aircraft symbol on the horizon indicates 10 degrees, and if you take off your hands of the side stick, the aircraft will magically stay at 10 degrees without further inputs required from your side. The same applies to the bank angle. Up to 33 degrees of bank, you simply need to set the required bank angle to start the turn, and if you release the side stick, the aircraft will maintain the attitude and the bank angle set by you. Basically, the less you touch, the better it is. The Boeing 737 does not auto-trim your inputs during normal flight envelopes. This means that you need to constantly use the trim switches in order to release the force on the yoke. For example, if you start a turn without applying the back pressure on the control and then the trim, the aircraft will start to descend. So if I have to compare these two aircraft types, I would say that the Airbus A320 reduces the pilot workload substantially because it is extremely easy to fly it manually, while the Boeing 737 requires a higher workload since you need to trim and apply back pressure like a single engine piston aircraft. And this, from my point of view, makes the Boeing 737 a more enjoyable and fun aircraft to fly without autopilot. At the end of the day, the Boeing 737 is just a big Cessna. Now let's compare these two planes during day-to-day line operations. The Airbus A320's families have been built around the pilot. It is designed to make everyday operation as smooth and as comfortable as possible. The systems, equipment and the cockpit layout really reduces the pilot workload during normal operations. The Airbus A320 systems, such as the fly-by-wire, the FADEC and so on, really assist the pilots during the flight operations. And do not forget, it also has a table. Let me give you an example. During the engine start of the Boeing 737, you need to monitor the start sequence, apply fuel when maximum motoring is reached, and be ready to cut the fuel in case of abnormal start conditions occur. On the Airbus A320, all this is done automatically. You simply need to set the engine mode selector to start ignition, put the engine master on, and all the rest is taken care of by the plane. And this is applicable to many other procedures, and as you can imagine, on a 4 or 6 sectors days, the Airbus A320's family will make you less tired. How about non-normal operation? Here becomes very interesting. Some pilots that have flown both types prefer the Airbus A320s, and some pilots prefer the Boeing 737. Again, this is just a personal opinion. If you ask me on which aircraft would I like to have an engine failure, I would answer on none of them. However, if I have to face a serious malfunction, I would prefer to have it on the Boeing 737. I say so because the Boeing 737 is a simpler and more direct aircraft, and that is what you want during a serious malfunction. I have to say, however, that the Airbus A320 does a great job on keeping a very high situational awareness of the pilots during a system failure or malfunction, because it has the ECAM. Let me give you some examples. If you lose an engine with the Airbus A320, the ECAM will show you all the affected system, the aircraft landing capability, for example if you are CAT3, CAT1, CAT2 and so on, and the various restrictions. This for sure increases your situational awareness. On the Boeing 737, it's the pilot that should have a good system knowledge and check all related limitations. Let me give you another example. We said that if an abnormal engine start occurs on the Boeing 737, you need to cut fuel, apply the relative checklist and procedure, motor the engine to clear the fuel, and if you think that is appropriate, perform another start attempt. Do you know what happens if the same things occurs on the Airbus A320s? The FADEC will cut off the fuel, motor the engine, and perform another engine start attempt with no crew actions required. All this Airbus technology comes with a price, of course, and when you have a serious malfunction, this situation could become more complex than the same failure on the Boeing 737. You cannot break what you don't have. I have to say that these two types of planes were not designed at the same time. The Airbus A320 has been built many years later compared to the Boeing 737, and the technology available to Airbus was a lot more advanced. Overall, I think that these two aircraft are simply amazing. The Airbus A320 has a more technology and helps you on everyday operations, and the Boeing 737 is a very enjoyable aircraft to fly. So I cannot really decide which is the best. However, at this point in my career, I'm very happy to change to the Airbus A320, start flying soon, and hopefully take you on board one day. Let me know in the comment below which family do you prefer. Do you prefer the Airbus A320s or the Boeing 737s? Thanks for watching, and I wish you all the best. Jack, we can set this.